a load on real bearing is as follows. A load of fifty thousand newtons acting 20% of time. 20% of time at 100 RPM. Right? And a load of 40,000 newtons acting 50% of time at 50 RPM. In the resting percentage, time at 200 RPM. The load varies from 40,000 newtons to 1 lakh newtons. 40,000 newtons to 1 lakh newtons varies. Load varies from 40,000 to 10,000, not 1 lakh. 40,000 to 10,000 newtons linearly select a roller bearing from NU series, NU23 series. So the series also specified here, NU23 series, for a life of 4,000 hours. 4,000 hours. The environment temperature is 150 degrees centigrade. Environment temperature is 150 degrees centigrade. Right, so this is similar to your previous problem when the bearing is subjected to variable loading. Right, so how to select the bearing, suitable bearing? But here it is specified it is a roller bearing, and particularly from NU23 series. Now you just open the data book and look at for NU23 series bearing table. All of you open the data books, then go to NU23 roller bearing series. Right? So for 50,000 newtons for 20% of time, 40,000 newtons for 50% of time. In the resting percentage, 50 plus 20, 70, right? What is the remaining percentage of time? 100 minus 70, 30%. So at 30%, the load varies linearly from 40,000 newtons to 10,000 newtons. Okay, right? First, you write down the given data. Given that it is a roller bearing. Roller bearing of NU23 series. Roller bearing of NU23 series. Now, indicate the loads. 50,000 newtons, then second load is 40,000 newtons, and what about the third load? It is linearly varying from 40,000 to 10,000. So that means initially the load is 40,000 newtons here and it reaches to 10,000 newtons. Right, so if you take the graph, you get loading diagram for the remaining percentage. You will get like this, right? Initially it is at 40,000 newtons and here it is 10,000 newtons. Then average of these two, 40,000 plus 10,000 by 2, you will get 50,000 by 2, 25,000 newtons as the third load. 25,000 newtons. All of you got it? How to calculate variable load, resultant load from the variable load of 40,000 to 10,000 newtons, right? Since it is a linearly varying load, you can find out the area of this, right? Now here, what is the RPM values? 50,000 newtons. What is the time? Load. Then time. First 20%. Then next 50%. What about the remaining? Right? Total must be 1. Then speed. Speed is equal to, what is the speed value? 100 rpm, 50 rpm, 100, 50. Then what about the rest of the time? 200 rpm. Okay, then life is given. Life in hours. That is equal to 4,000 hours, right? From this, first you calculate life in million revolutions. What is the formula? 60 N LH by 10 to the power of 6. 10 to the power of 6. Right, so you calculate the value of life in million revolutions. 60 into N into LH divided by 10 to the power of 6. What is the n value here? The average of this, n is equal to the average of this value. What is the average? 200 plus 50, 250 plus 100, 350 by 3. That is the n value.
116.66.
116.66.
Double six.
Right, you substitute here.
116 point data.
Okay. 116. Now you calculate the life in million revolutions. Revolutions per minute here, and this is the time. Sorry, you need to calculate the n value. N is equal to 20. So time into speed. and here it is 25, and here it is 60. Sorry. Revolutions in minute cycle. Now 20 plus 25 plus 60. How much it is? 105. This is n value, not this average. Just to make it correction here. Okay. So this is 0.2 minutes. 0.2 minute. 1 minute. 100 revolutions. In 1 minute, 100 revolutions. 0.2 minutes, only 20 revolutions. In 1 minute, 50 revolutions. Half minute, 25 revolutions only. In 1 minute, 200 revolutions. 0.3 minutes, 60 revolutions. Total 105 revolutions per minute. 105 revolutions per minute. So now here you need to consider this n value, 105 into 4000 divided by 10 to the power of 6.
25.2, sir.
24.2.
25.2, sir.
25.2. So what is this value? Life in million revolutions.
Life in.
If you put MR here, you need to indicate the units. Right? So if MR is not there, you have to indicate the MR here. Right? Either before the default decimal or after the numerical value. You need to indicate. Right? So now you have the life. Now you have to find out the bearing load. When the variable loading is given on the bearing, then equivalent load you need to calculate. Okay, so equivalent load, P is equal to, what is the formula? P1 cube N1 plus P2 cube N2 plus P3 cube N3 divided by sigma n. Sigma n is nothing but capital N, or that is equal to n1 plus n2 plus n3. Anything is same. Sigma n or capital N or n1 plus n2 plus n3. Right? Right, I think you have the power here. 1/3, yeah?
1/3. 36.4, sir.
How much?
36.4.
56, sir.
36, sir.
36 point.
36.36, sir. 36,336, sir.
Okay, na.
36,336, sir.
Right. Newtons.
Sir, 36.36, sir.
36, sir.
36.36, 0.4.
Right, so this is equivalent load, cubic mean load. This is called a cubic mean load. Now, you know the life in million revolutions, and you know the p-value. You can find out the dynamic load carrying capacity. We know that L by life in million revolutions equal to C by P whole to the power of K. What is K here? It's a ball bearing, roller bearing. Right? K is equal to 10 by 3. Implies L is equal to 25.2. Is equal to C is unknown. P is 36,336 whole to the power of 10 by 3. Right? You need to remember K is equal to 10 by 3 or 3.33 for roller bearing. Right? From this, you calculate C value.
C and the chapter.
Anybody got the value? For this C value, you select a bearing number from NU23 series. For this C value, you select the bearing number from NU23 series. NU23, what is the type of bearing? For the given application is NU2310, na?
Yes, sir.
What is the bearing temperature? Bearing temperature is turned. Right? Any information on bearing number? Is that bearing temperature?
150 degrees is not the question.
Okay, not in the problem, in the data book. Right? So, the bearing number for the given application is NU2310. Is it okay? So now, do you want to continue another iteration or not? Is it necessary here? Do you want to perform another iteration? Is it required?